After the Hour, coming to you from Surf City, USA. Peter Greenberg here from Huntington Beach, California. Taking your calls at 888-887-3837. That's 888-88-PETER. And we've just been talking to the 17-year-old champion surfer, Courtney Conlog. And I asked her if she was ever going to end up in the museum run by my next guest. And she said she's hoping to. She's been there. Of course, it's the International Surf Museum right here in Huntington Beach. And his name is Gary Sahagan. Hey, Gary.
Hi. How you doing, Peter?
Good. Now, I know you're a surfer. You've been surfing since the 60s, right?
Yes, I have.
And every day?
I went out today, yes.
And?
Not every day.
But every day you can.
Every day I can.
What's changed since you started surfing here in the 60s? Not just in terms of the surf and the topography, but also just Huntington Beach itself.
Well, the culture itself has had quite a shift. Back in the 60s, surfers were a lot less accepted as a member of the culture. We were a little kind of outlawish.
And how did you mandate that? How did you manifest that?
Well, we were just...
Drugs were not involved now, were they, Gary?
Oh, well, yes, they were.
Okay.
No, the alcohol, drugs, whatever we get our whole...
Shocked to hear the gambling's going on in Rich's casino.
Well, it was Oil City back then. There was quite a lot of roughnecks around town, and there was just an atmosphere of just debauchery, I think, that pervaded the situation.
And somehow you survived.
Oh, barely. I got away for about 10 years.
So when did the museum start?
The museum started in the mid-80s. And kind of came as a manifestation of a realtor from Canada, Natalie Coach. And she was watching there all the surfers going back and forth, said, hey, there should be a surfing museum. And there was a bunch of us, we had a surf club, and she talked to us, among other people, and said, what do I need to do? And just started collecting a lot of paraphernalia and artifacts.
Now, you founded the Huntington Beach Longboard Crew back in 85.
Yes, about the same time.
See, I started learning how to surf on longboards, but I'm talking about 15-foot mahogany longboards that weighed 150 pounds each with no skeg.
Well, that was back in the 40s. And so.
I'm not that old. No, I did that in the late 60s, early 70s.
Well, if you got on one of those old Tom Blake paddle boards, the cigar box, the kook box, they call it, they fill up with water with a little plug.
I even had a drain plug on.
Right. Yeah. I paddled those around a lot when I was a kid in the Lido Isle around Newport Harbor. They just left them on the docks, and you would pull them off and paddle them around and stick them back where you left. You didn't even know who they were owned by.
Well, I've got two of the original ones that I have actually mounted at my house in New York right now, up on the wall at the beach house, because the other two, I think, are the Museum of the Bishop Museum in Hawaii, because they're not easy to find anymore.
Well, they make quite a few of them. They're actually made by a ladder company out in L.A., and if you open up the insides of them, they look like a ladder on the inside.
They do, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yes, they had a corner of the ladder company devoted to making these kook boxes.
But we're talking, 30 years ago. You don't see those around anymore.
Well, there's one hanging in the lobby here.
Hanging in the lobby, but you don't see them in the water.
Not too often.
No. I just want to make sure we're on the right track here.
Yes.
So what's different about the museum? What am I going to... Obviously, I'm going to see surfboards in the museum, but what else?
Well, we rotate the exhibit around as much as we can. We're all volunteers. So right now we have Surfboard Shapers Part 1, the wooden years. So we actually do have some of those wooden boards on display.
I feel right at home there, though.
You would. You would love it. We're focused on Duke Kahanamoku as the first shaper that came to California and taught a couple of local Huntington Beach boys, Bud Higgins and Gene Belshi.
What about Mickey?
Mickey Munoz?
Yeah.
Oh, well, he was... a little later, but he was definitely part of the wooden era.
He was.
Mm-hmm. Mickey's a good friend of mine.
Well, I should tell you that in the interest of full disclosure, my uncle grew up around here, was one of the original surfers, then went to Hawaii with Duke, and started a company called Jams World.
Oh, yes.
That's my uncle, Dave Rocklin, who, and when Dave died about 6 years ago, his funeral service, where I spoke, was at the Royal Hawaiian, where he was one of the original Beach Boys, one of the original singing Beach Boys on the beach. And everybody showed up with their ukuleles, everybody showed up with their jams, everybody showed up with their catamarans, and it was one huge 3,000-person party.
That sounds like an amazing event.
And all the surfers were out there in tribute to him.
Well, jams are still around. We had a display on jams still in our archives.
Yeah, and I still have them. Are you kidding? I still wear them.
Very good.
And they still make them. They still make them in Honolulu, absolutely.
They actually make them here, too.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes.
See? You got something to call you didn't
right.
even know about.
That's right.
I should actually search my my closet to see what I can give you for the museum.
That would be wonderful, because
yeah.
we are planning on having a clothing exhibit with the history of the surf trunk and the wetsuit.
And the long shorts, because that's what really started.
Yes. Oh, definitely.
That was jams.
Yes. The long, long jams.
Absolutely.
That's the ones we had on display.
Oh, okay. We're in sync now. We're doing it. What's the most unusual thing you've got in your collection?
Well, one of our prized possessions is the original Endless Summer camera that Bruce Brown shot the whole movie with. That's a very unique artifact because it was one of the first built with a water housing that you could mount on a surfboard. Bruce Brown created or made the housing himself.
Well, my biggest thrill, I actually had the original poster, the original black light. It was like pink and orange poster.
Yes.
I still have it on the wall back in New York. Yeah.
Well, we'll have to get a sign by Robert August, Mike Hinson, and Bruce Brown. They're still signing them.
I'm ready.
Okay, I'll make it happen.
Gary Sahagun, who's still surfing now, and of course is on the International Surf Museum. He's on the board of directors, and of course the founder of the infamous Huntington Beach Longboard Crew. Thanks so much, man. That music means we're out of time for the show.